हेलो फ्रेंड्स, आई एम पायल प्रियदर्शनी, पीजीटी बायोटेक्नोलॉजी, केंद्रीय विद्यालय नंबर 3, दिल्ली कैंट. टुडे आई एम हेयर विद माय टॉपिक सर्च ऑफ जेनेटिक मटेरियल. विद द स्टार्ट ऑफ दिस टॉपिक, फर्स्ट ऑफ ऑल लेट्स आंसर दोज क्वेश्चन विच आई आस्क्ड यू इन माय लास्ट सेशन. माय फर्स्ट क्वेश्चन वाज व्हाट आर न्यूक्लियोइड. सो नाउ वी नो nucleoids is a central region in a prokaryotic cell like bacteria that contains the chromosome and that has no surrounding membrane. So nucleoids are the chromosome of the bacteria and they do not have any membrane to enclose that genetic material. Next question, what are the differences between positive and negative supercoalings? So here are the answer. Positive supercoiling is overwound and negative supercoiling is underwound. As we know, in BDNA there are 10 base sequences in one turn. So if this number of bases goes on increasing by the wounding of the DNA helix, and if the number of base pairs goes on increasing, that will give you the positive supercoilings. And if the number of base pairs per turn goes on decreasing due to the coiling of the DNA helix, it will give you negative supercoilings. And the another difference between these two is direction of twisting. If twisting is in the direction of DNA helix, it is positive supercoiling, and if it is opposite to the direction of DNA helix, it is negative supercoilings. So these are the differences between positive and negative supercoilings. Next question is, why DNA packaging is needed? Why it is so important for the cell? So as we know, DNA packaging is an important process in living cells. Without it, a cell is not able to accommodate the large amount of DNA that is stored in inside. So the DNA is very much larger in size as compared to the size of the cell and the nucleus. So the DNA needs to be packaged in somehow so that it can easily be accommodated in a small size of cells or nucleus. Next question is, what are the different proteins involved in nucleosome model? So here is the answer. There are two types of proteins which involve in nucleosome model in the packaging of the DNA in the eukaryotic cells. The one is histone proteins, which includes H1, H2A, H2B, H3 and H4. These are the 5 types of histone proteins which help in the nucleosome formation in the eukaryotic cell. Apart from histone proteins, there are some non-histone proteins like scaffold protein, DNA polymerase, heterochromatin, protein 1 and polycomb proteins. So these non-histone proteins also help in packaging of the DNA as well as in some other function of DNA like replication and transcription and all. The next question is, what are the different types of chromosome depending on their centromere position? So here is the answer. There are 6 types of chromosomes depending on the position of centromere. The one is metacentric. In the metacentric chromosome, the centromere present in between the two arms of the chromosome and they give the V shape to the chromosome. In submetacentric, the centromere is not exactly at the middle of the two arms of the chromosome and it gives L shape to the chromosome. In acrocentric chromosome, the centromere present at one of the ends of the arms of the DNA and it give J shape to the chromosome. In telocentric chromosome, the centromere present at the end of the chromosome and it gives I shape to the chromosome. And in acentric chromosome, there are no any centromere, and in dicentric and polycentric, they have more than one centromere in the chromosome. So these are different types of chromosome depending on the position of centromere. Now let's start the today's topic from the chapter Molecular Basis of Inheritance of class 12th, Search of Genetic Material. At the time when many of the scientists were involved to find out the structure of the DNA, few of them were trying to find out the nature, the chemical nature of the genetic material, whether it is DNA or RNA or a protein, which actually passes the information from one generation to another. So today we'll learn about the features of genetic material, what should be the features of a genetic material, what makes the biomolecule the genetic material. Next to that, we will learn about Griffith experiment and step taken out by the Griffith to find out the nature of genetic material, which is followed by Avery, MacLeod and McCarty. They also perform an experiment to find out the nature of genetic material, and finally the Hershey and Chase experiment, who concluded that genetic material is DNA, it is not RNA and not protein. So, as I explained you in my last slide, there are some scientists who contributed in searching the genetic material. The first who contributed in the search of genetic material was Frederick Griffith, who worked on rat using the Streptococcus pneumonia bacteria to find out the chemical nature of genetic material. The Griffith experiment was followed by three another scientists, Oswald Avery, Colin MacLeod and Maclean McCarty. They also trying to find out the chemical nature of genetic material, and finally Hershey and Chase, Alfred Hershey and Martha Chase contributed to find out the nature of genetic material. Now, let's know about the features of genetic material. What makes the biomolecule genetic material? Do we know what is the meaning of genetic material? Yes, genetic material is that biomolecule which transfer the information from one generation to another. Whatever characters, whatever traits, whatever phenotype is there in the parents, that is being carried out to their offspring. So, whatever biomolecules are there which can transfer all this information from parents to offspring is considered as genetic material. So, according to some biologists, there are some features which must be there in a genetic material, and these features are, they must contain complex information which are being transferred from parents to their offspring should be there in genetic material. The next feature of genetic material is it should replicate faithfully. If we talk about cell division like mitosis and meiosis, the cell divides, and if cell divides, the chromosome must be same in case of mitosis, or chromosome should get half in case of meiosis, but in both the cases the DNA must be get replicated. The next feature of genetic material should be it code phenotype. Phenotype means the external appearance of any living organism. So, a genetic material must encode the external appearance of any living organism. And the last but not the least, the genetic material must be capable of change. Without change, organism would be incapable of variation and adaptation, and evolution could not occur. So, genetic material must be capable of change, so that there will be evolution in the living organism, there will be adaptation in the living organism. Without change, evolution cannot occur. Without the change in the genetic material, or without the change in the DNA sequences, the adaptation cannot occur. So, let's conclude all these points. The features of a genetic material, they must contain complex information, they must replicate faithfully, they must encode phenotype, and they must be capable of change, because without change, evolution and adaptation cannot be happen in the living system. So, change in the genetic material is very much essential for the living system. Now, let us know about the first experiment performed by Griffith to identify the chemical nature of genetic material. Griffith reported his experiment in 1928, and he used a bacteria which caused the pneumonia disease, and the bacteria was Streptococcus pneumoniae, and he found two strains of that bacteria. One was type 3S and second was type 2R. there was a difference in the cell wall, the outermost layer of the bacteria in 3S and 2R. The 3S strain has a smooth polysaccharide coat which makes it resistant to the immune system of mice. 3S is having a polysaccharide coat in their cell wall which makes it smooth, and that is why it has been given the name 3S. S stands for smooth, and smoothness is because of the polysaccharide coat in the cell wall of the bacteria. But this cell wall of bacteria which is having polysaccharide, this polysaccharide was not there in 2R strain of the bacteria, and that is why the 2R bacteria appears to be rough from the outer side, and this R stands for the roughness of the bacteria. And this roughness of the bacteria in the outer cell wall is because of the lack of the polysaccharide in their cell wall. So, 3S bacteria was able to cause the pneumonia disease. So, 3S was virulent in nature, while 2R was non-virulent because it was killed by the immune system of the living organism. So, with the start of the Griffith experiment, Griffith first injected type 2R bacteria. As we know, type 2R bacteria is non-virulent in nature. It cannot cause the disease because it will be destroyed, it will be digested by the immune system of the living organism. So, when he injected type 2R bacteria into mice, he found that the mice was lived and no bacteria were observed in the blood. So, you can see in the slide, when Griffith injected type 2R bacteria in mice, after certain time the mice was live, because as type 2R bacteria was non-virulent in nature, mice did not get any type of infection from that bacteria and the mice was live. In the next step of the experiment, Griffith injected type 3S bacteria into mice, which caused the mice to develop pneumonia and die. The bacteria were recovered from their blood. So, in this stage of the experiment, Griffith used 3S, which was virulent in nature, which caused the disease, pneumonia disease to the mice, and because of the virulency of the 3S bacteria, the mice get die. So, it was the second stage of the Griffith's experiment, which was expected by the Griffith. In the third experiment by the Griffith, Griffith injected large amount of heat killed type 3S bacteria. Heat killed means giving the heat to the bacteria, and because of the heating effect the bacteria can die, and because of the death of the bacteria the virulency will also get denatured, and the heat killed bacteria cannot cause the disease to the mice. So, the Griffith injected this heat killed 3S bacteria to the mice, and after certain time he found that the mice was live as expected by the Griffith, because heat killed 3S bacteria is not virulent in nature, because heating kills the virulency of the 3S bacteria. So, till here the result was expected by the Griffith, and there was no any surprise in their experiment. But in the last stage of the experiment, when Griffith used a mixture of 2R and heat killed 3S bacteria and injected in the mice, as expected by the Griffith, the mice should be live, because type 2R is already non-virulent in nature, and heat killed 3S is also non-virulent in nature because heating kills the virulency of the bacteria. So, the expected result should be the mice should live, but he found the mice dead after the injection of heat killed 3S bacteria and 2R bacteria. So, Griffith was very much surprised why it happens, but he was not able to find out what was the reason of this. So, he lastly concluded that type 2R bacteria had somehow been transformed, acquiring the genetic virulence of the dead type 3S bacteria. So, according to Griffith, something has get transferred to the 2R from 3S, heat killed 3S bacteria, and make the 2R virulent, and because of the virulency in the 2R bacteria, the mice get die. What was that genetic material was not very much known by the Griffith, so he called it as transforming principle. So, to find out the nature of the transforming principle, another three scientists, Oswald Avery, Maclean McCarty and Colin MacLeod, followed the Griffith experiment to find out the chemical nature of transforming principle, and they reported their experiment in 1944. So, what they did is, they took the homogenized of heat killed Thoris bacteria and filtered. We can understand this here also. What they did is, they took Thoris heat killed bacteria. Heat killed bacteria means these bacteria are non-virulent. Non-virulent means it cannot cause the disease. They homogenize all those cells and filter these homogenized cells and collected the filtrate. So, they collected the filtrate of the mixture. So, in the first phase of their experiment, what they did is, they took the filtrate of the Thoris heat kill bacteria and added proteinase enzyme to the filtrate. Proteinase enzyme will digest all the protein present in the filtrate. So, it means only DNA and RNA is present in this mixture, and they transfer this mixture to the culture of 2R bacteria. And then they transfer all this mixture in an agar plate, and they found after a certain time there were the colonies of Thoris as well as 2R. So, it means according to them, if protein would be the genetic material, so in the absence of protein there should not be any colonies of Thoris bacteria, but it did not happen like so. They found the colonies of Thoris bacteria. It means the protein is not the genetic material, it may be DNA or RNA. So, in the second phase of their experiment, they added RNA's enzyme in the filtrate. RNAs digest all the RNA present in the filtrate. It means the filtrate is not having RNA molecule, and the RNA lacking filtrate was poured in the culture of 2R bacteria. And after that, they transfer all this mixture in the culture media, and they found that there were again the colonies of Thoris bacteria and 2R bacteria. It means the RNA is not being transferred from Thoris to 2R. If RNA would be the transforming principle, then there must not be any Thoris colonies in the culture media. So, finally, in the third step of the experiment, they took the filtrate and they added DNA's enzyme. DNA's enzyme will digest all the DNA of the filtrate, and then they transfer the filtrate lacking the DNA into the culture of 2R bacteria. And when they transfer this mixture in the agar plate, they found that there were only 2R bacteria on the culture plate. No Thoris bacteria colony were appear on the plate. It means DNA must be genetic material. In the absence of that DNA, there was no any third S colony of the bacteria, and they concluded that it must be DNA which is being transferred from third S heat kill bacteria to 2R bacteria, which convert this 2R bacteria in virulent, and because of the conversion of 2R bacteria in third S bacteria, the mice get die. Here we can conclude all this experiment. So, first they homogenized the heat killed third S bacteria and filtered. They broken down all the cell parts of the heat killed third S bacteria and collected the filter. After the filtration, they collected the filtrate. In the filtrate, first they added the proteinase enzyme like trypsin and chemotrypsin. Proteinase enzyme known to break all the proteins of the filtrate, and then they poured the extract in culture of type 2R bacteria, and they found the colonies of 2R as well as 3S bacteria. So, protein should not be the genetic material. In the next step, they added ribonuclease, an enzyme that destroy RNA in the filtrate. They poured the extract in culture of type 2R bacteria and found the colonies of type 2R as well as type 3S bacteria. It means RNA should not be the genetic material. And in the last step of their experiment, they added DNase enzyme which is capable of destroying DNA in the filtrate. They poured the extract in culture of type 2R bacteria and they found only colonies of type 2R bacteria. There was no any 3S bacteria developed in the culture. That means DNA should be the genetic material which is being transferred from heat kill to 2R. In the absence of DNA, there was no any transformation in 2R bacteria. So, there were no any colonies of 3S bacteria in the culture plate. But many biologists still refuses to accept the idea, however still preferring the hypothesis that the genetic material is protein. Many of the scientists were refused all those hypothesis, all those conclusion given by the all these three scientists, Avery, MacLeod and McCarthy. And according to some of the biologists, they were still saying that the genetic material is protein, not the DNA, not the RNA. So, to find out the chemical nature of genetic material, finally, the two another scientists, Hershey and Chase, performed their experiment on T2 bacteriophage and reported their result in 1952. Hershey and Chase were doing the experiment on bacteriophage. Do you know what are bacteriophages? Yes, bacteriophages are the viruses which kills the bacteria. They complete their life cycle through the bacteria, and because of that the bacteria get killed up. So, here Hershey and Chase worked with bacteriophages, a virus that infect bacteria, which in turn produce more viruses. Bacteriophages are made up of two important biomolecules. One is DNA, which is regarded as the genetic material of the bacteriophages, and the protein. Protein encloses the genetic material. The scientist wanted to know which substance is genetic material in the bacteriophage, whether it is DNA or protein. Let's know about the structure of bacteriophage. Hershey and Chase were doing their experiment on T2 bacteriophage. This is the typical structure of T2 bacteriophage. This one is the capsid. This capsid is made up of protein, and this protein coat encloses the genetic material of the bacteriophage. The genetic material of bacteriophage is DNA. This part of the bacteriophage is considered as collar. This one is sheet. Here it is base plate, then the spike and the tail fiber. So, this is a typical structure of bacteriophage. Before knowing about the experiments performed by Hershey and Chase, First of all, let's know about the life cycle of bacteriophage. How the bacteriophage completes its life cycle through the bacteria, and how what happens to the bacteria, why it is being killed up by the bacteriophage. So here is the life cycle of the bacteriophage. We can understand in this way. Suppose this is a bacteria, and as we know, bacteria is having their own DNA. This is the bacterial DNA, and first of all, the bacteriophage infect the bacteria with the help of their tail fiber and transfer its genetic material inside the bacteria. This is called phage DNA. Here is the bacterial DNA. This part of bacteriophage lacking the phage DNA is called empty bacteriophage or ghost. Now, because of the certain enzyme associated with the phage DNA, that enzyme digests the bacterial DNA, and the bacterial DNA is being digested up. So, in the next phase of the life cycle of the bacteriophage, this empty bacteriophage will get removed, and this phage DNA will encode certain enzymes which will digest all the bacterial chromosome. So, these are the digested bacterial chromosome. Next to this, the phage DNA with the help of certain enzyme will get replicated inside the bacteria, and this phage DNA will undergo transcription and translation to synthesize the protein which will make the parts of the bacteriophage like capsid, tail fiber, basal sheets and all that. And all these phage DNA will get incorporated inside the capsid, all the parts get packed themselves to make the complete bacteriophage. Now, these bacteriophages will secrete out some enzymes to digest the cell wall of the bacteriophage, and because of that, the bacteriophage will get released out more in number. So, this is how the bacteriophage completes its life cycle. And while completing the life cycle, the bacteria get killed up by the bacteriophage. So, here in the slide you can know it much better. So, first of all, the bacteriophage will infect the E. coli cell and transfer its DNA inside the E. coli cell. Now, the phage chromosome associated enzymes will digest the bacterial chromosome, and the bacterial chromosome will totally broken down. Now, with the some certain enzymes and proteins, the phage chromosome will get replicated, and after the completion of replication, the phage DNA will undergo transcription and translation to synthesize a protein which will make all the parts of the bacteriophage. As we know, there are only two components in the bacteriophage, one is the protein and another is DNA. So, all the parts of the bacteriophage will be synthesized by the phage DNA, and all these parts of the bacteriophages will assemble themselves. Phage DNA will get incorporated inside the head of this bacteriophage, and they will release certain enzymes to digest the cell wall, and all these bacteriophages will get out from the E. coli cells. So, while completing this life cycle, the bacteria is being killed up by the bacteriophage. So, this is all about the life cycle of the bacteriophage. Now, let us know about the experiment performed by the Hershey and Chase. The first question which comes is, why radioactive phosphorus and sulfur? In Hershey and Chase, they used radioactive phosphorus and sulfur. Radioactivity in the atoms of the elements help in tracing out the various molecules inside the cells. That is why they took radioactive elements. Why phosphorus? Because phosphorus is one of the major component of the DNA. And why sulfur? Because sulfur is one of the major component of the protein. So, to find out whether it is DNA or protein is a genetic material, they took radioactive phosphorus and sulfur to find out the chemical nature of genetic material. So, first Hershey and Chase grew E. coli cell in a medium containing 32 phosphorus and infected the bacteria with T2 so that all the new phases would have DNA labeled with P32. Let us know in this like this. What they did is, they grew the E. coli cells. As we know, the bacteriophage complete their life cycle with the help of E. coli cells. So, they grew E. coli cells in the medium containing P32. P32 is radioactive phosphorus, and phosphorus is the major component of the DNA. So, it was a first phase. In second phase, they took E. coli cell in the culture medium, and in this medium, they used S35 as radioactive atom, and S35 is a part of the protein. These are the E. coli cells. So, after growing the bacteriophages inside the E. coli cells, they also transfer the bacteriophages inside the second phase colonies of the bacteria. So, after certain time, the bacteriophage get labeled with P32 as phosphorus is present in the DNA, and in this phase they found this radioactive sulfur in the proteinous part of the bacteriophage, S35. So, after getting labeled bacteriophages as P32 and S35, they again transfer these radioactive labeled bacteriophage in the another medium of E. coli cells. And culture the bacteriophage with normal medium without any radioactive atoms. Here are the E. coli cells in a culture medium, and they transfer bacteriophage with P32, and in another culture medium they transferred the bacteriophage labeled with S35. after the completion of the fish life cycle, they removed all the empty bacteriophage, host bacteriophage, with the help of blender. Due to blending of the mixture, all the host of the bacteriophage will get removed, and the bacteriophage, as we know, will complete their life cycle inside the E. coli cell. So, after getting the culture of the bacteriophage inside the medium, they found that there were P32 in the culture medium, while there was no S35 in the medium. So, if protein would be the genetic material, it must get transferred from labeled bacteriophage to the cultured bacteriophages in E. coli cells, but they did not find any S35 bacteriophage in the culture medium. While in this case, they found radioactive phosphorus after culturing the radioactive bacteriophage in the E. coli cell in normal medium, and they concluded that the DNA should be the genetic material, because while completing the life cycle, the phosphorus P32 were found in the culture medium, and in this way they concluded the DNA is genetic material, not the RNA, not the protein. So, here we can understand this more clearly. So, first Hershey and Chase grew E. coli in a medium containing P32 and infected the bacteria with T2, so that all the new phases would have DNA labeled with P32. So, firstly they grew the bacteriophage with E. coli cells having radioactive phosphorus P32, and in the second phase they grew the bacteriophages in E. coli cells having the radioactive S35 sulfur atom in the medium. And after growing the bacteriophage in the medium with radioactive atoms, they found radioactive labeled S35 bacteriophage and radioactive labeled P32 bacteriophage. After that, they infected these two different bacteriophages in two different culture medium having normal E. coli cells. And after the completion of the experiment, they found that in E. coli cells there was P32, while in the second phase there was no any S35 in the bacterial cells. So, if protein would be the genetic material and sulfur is a part of the protein, the sulfur should be there in the culture medium, in the bacteria or in the phages, but it was not there. So, finally, Hershey and Chase concluded that DNA is genetic material, because they found P32 after the completion of the life cycle of the bacteriophage in the E. coli cells. So, this was the conclusion of Hershey and Chase, that DNA is genetic material, it is not RNA and it is not protein. So, now we know that out of DNA, RNA and protein, DNA is considered as genetic material, because it transfers all the information of parents to the offspring. So, let us conclude all the concept which we learned today. The first was Griffith experiment. The Griffith used two type of Streptococcus pneumoniae. The one was 2R, which was non-virulent, and another strain of Streptococcus pneumoniae was 3S, which was virulent. The major difference in between these two Streptococcus pneumoniae was the presence of polysaccharide in the coat of the cell wall of the 3S bacteria. which gives the smoothness in the cell wall, while there was no any polysaccharide in the cell wall of the 2R bacteria, which gives roughness to the cell wall of 2R bacteria. So, the first step of Griffith experiment was he used 2R bacteria injected in the mice. After certain time, he found mice to be live. So, it means 2R is non-virulent in nature and it was being digested by the immune system of the mice. So, no bacteria were found in the blood of the mice and mice were live. In the second phase, he used 3S bacteria injected in the mice, and after certain time he found that mice was dead, and death of the mice is because of the virulency nature of the 3S bacteria, and because of the virulency of 3S bacteria the mice get die. In the third phase, Griffith used heat killed 3S bacteria. Heat killed means the virulency of the bacteria will be destroyed by the heating of the 3S bacteria. So, the heat killed bacteria is no more virulent in nature. When injected in the mice found to be live. So, these three experiments were performed by the Griffith, and the result was as expected by the Griffith. But then in fourth step, Griffith used a mixture of 2R and heat killed 3S bacteria. So, if we talk about the virulency, 2R is already non-virulent and heat killed become non-virulent by the heating of the 3S bacteria. So, as per expected by the Griffith, the mixture of these two bacteria should not cause the pneumonia disease, and when it is being injected in the mice should get live, but he found mice to be dead. So, it was very much surprising for the Griffith ki what makes the mice dead, and he concluded that something has get transferred from heat killed 3S bacteria to this 2R bacteria and make this 2R virulent, and because of the virulency the mice get die. So, Griffith was not able to find out actually which was the chemical which actually transferred from 3S heat killed to 2R. So, he called that chemical which transferred from 3S to 2R as transforming principle. The chemical nature was not explained by the Griffith. So, to know the chemical nature of the transforming principle, the Griffith experiment was followed by another three scientists, Avery, MacLeod and McCarty. They carried out the experiment of the Griffith. They took the homogenized cells of 3S heat kill bacteria. They filtered the cells. They collected the filtrate. In the first step of their experiment, they added the proteinase enzyme. Proteinase enzyme digested all the protein present in the filtrate, and when they poured the filtrate lacking the protein in the culture of 2R bacteria, after certain time they found the colonies of 3S bacteria. It means ki protein is not the genetic material, because if protein would be the genetic material, in the absence of protein there would not be any 3S bacteria, but they found the colonies of 3S bacteria in their first step of experiment. In the second step of their experiment, they added RNase enzyme in the filtrate. RNase enzyme will digest all the RNA present in the filtrate, and then they poured those filtrate lacking the RNA in the culture of 2R bacteria. After certain time, again they found the colonies of 3S with the colonies of 2R. It means if RNA would be the genetic material, there should not be any colonies appear in culture plate of third S bacteria. While they got the colonies of third S bacteria in the absence of RNA, so they concluded that RNA should not be the genetic material. In the third step of their experiment, they added DNA's enzyme in the filtrate. DNA's enzyme will digest all the DNA present in filtrate, and when the filtrate lacking the DNA is poured in the culture of 2R bacteria, then after a certain time they found only type 2R bacteria's colonies in the culture plate, and hence they concluded that DNA should be the genetic material. In the absence of DNA, there was no any transformation in 2R bacteria, and that's why there was no any colonies appeared in the plate. But some of the biologists didn't accepted this result. They were still saying that the protein should be the genetic material, because the actual performer of the living system is protein, not the DNA and not the RNA. So finally, Hershey and Chase, using the radioactive phosphorus and sulfur, concluded that DNA is genetic material, it is not RNA, it is not protein. They grew E. coli cells in the medium containing P32 phosphorus, which is radioactive in nature. They infected the E. coli cells with the bacteriophage. After the completion of the life cycle of the bacteriophage, all the bacteriophage get labeled with the P32, and in the second phase they grew the E. coli cell with the radioactive sulfur S35 and infected the E. coli cells with bacteriophage. After the completion of the life cycle of bacteriophage, the bacteriophage get labeled with the S35, and when they infected bacteriophage separately in normal E. coli cells, after the completion of the life cycle of bacteriophage, when they removed the host of the bacteriophage with the blender, they found that P32 were present in the E. coli cells having the bacteriophage, while S35 was not there in the E. coli cell having bacteriophage. It means the material which get transferred from bacteriophage to the E. coli cell and then to E. coli cell to the bacteriophage is DNA having P32 as radioactive element. So finally, Hershey and Chase concluded that DNA is genetic material because radioactive phosphorus P32 appeared in the E. coli cells having bacteriophage. So I am going to end up my session now. In the next session, we will learn about replication, transcription, translation and all. Thank you very much.